Good afternoon, everyone. We'd like to welcome one of our featured pairings, I guess, this today. We were talking all about how the youth was kind of rising in this grouping, and they seem to deliver on the golf course as well. So I will introduce, we've got to my immediate left, Charley Hull, shot a 1-under-69 today. Lydia Coe, defending champion, who shot a 5-under-65 and is currently tied for the lead. And then Jennifer Kirby, who may be known to most of you as she's from Canada. She shot a 67, 367. Great rounds by all three of you ladies today. First off, Lydia, I'll just ask you as defending champion, how does it feel to get off to such a hot start in defending your title?
You know, I started off really well with a birdie, and but you know, when I have a birdie on the first hole, I haven't really played that well. So I was kind of nervous that I did make the birdie on the first, but you know, I guess birdies are good, and I think I played pretty solid today. So yeah, but I think I played good because the whole group, you know, seemed to, you know, play good and make lots of birdies. So we were in a really good rhythm as a whole group.
Charley, you're coming off a great week last week at the Solheim Cup where you played very well. I know probably not the finish you would have wanted today, finishing with two straight birdies, but overall, bogeys. Straight bogeys. But just how overall your round today, how did you feel about your game and overall and how you played?
Yeah, I played pretty solid. I just hit one on 17 and then I missed a silly little putt on the 18th, but I feel good. I just feel a bit tired because I haven't really been home for 6 weeks because I had quite a few competitions coming into the British Open, and I was back for home for 4 days, and then I come here and then Solheim. So I'm feeling pretty happy about my game and just going to practice some short putts after for a bit.
And Jennifer, great start for you as well. What is it like always when you come back and, you know, playing in these big events here in Canada?
I think that it really helped. I played in the Manulife earlier this season and I had a good tournament there. So I think that kind of eased the nerves into this one. And I felt very comfortable out there and ended up making a few putts and good round.
So I have to ask you as well, you're playing with a 17-year-old and a 16-year-old, and at 22, you definitely would normally be considered one of the younger players in the field. How did it feel to be the elder statesman, I guess, of this group?
I feel that they're wise beyond their years, and they're both great players, so it wasn't too bad, and I didn't feel too old.
And overall for you guys, what was it like kind of to have a younger pairing? I mean, did it make any difference to be playing with people who are around your own age and who might not have as much experience as some of these other players on the LPGA Tour?
It didn't really feel like a young pairing. I think we were all kind of like mature.
Yeah, I think we were very quick, at least. Yeah. That was nice.
Yeah.
And what is it like when you get going and you're watching? Lydia was making birdies early. Charley, you were making birdies. It seemed like everybody was kind of getting off to a pretty good start. What is it like in a grouping when you're kind of feeling that momentum of everybody else having a good round as well?
Yeah, I'd say, like Lydia said, we kind of just fed off each other and there was a lot of birdies and everyone had a lot of good chances. So it was nice to see.
Questions for any of these ladies?
Lydia, could you just go through your round a little bit? Did you have any really long birdies or any really short ones?
Up to the seventh hole, I went birdie, par, that kind of pattern. And I made par, par on 8-9, and then birdie 10, and then par all the way until the par 5, 14th. And then a bogey 15th, and then just pars coming in. And I wouldn't mind the color ratio on my scorecard if I looked on the computer. I had a couple. I had a tap-in one on 3, most of them were just reasonable distances. It wasn't extremely long or extremely short.
Question for Lydia. Do you stay in touch with Brian Alexander, your caddy, last year? And talk about how you got in touch with Bruce, your caddy, this year.
I know, like last year, I had a local caddy, you know, in Vancouver, and there was Brian, and we kind of did the same thing here, you know, decided to get a local, and Bruce has been a member here for many years, so we decide to have him on the bag.
Question for all three, and we're going to continue with the youthful theme. What's it like being on tour with so many youthful players? Does it increase the exuberance? Do you have more energy? Is it more comfortable knowing that there's a lot of players your own age out there? And then a second part to the question, please.
Who's going first?
You go.
Okay, I'll go. yeah, you know, I used to be one of the youngest ones out here, but I was really happy to see, I think, Brooke Henderson. She's younger than me, so I think that's how I kind of got off the youngest girl out here. And I think everybody, like, when you see the players on tour, it's definitely getting younger and younger, and I'm not sure why that is happening, but yeah, but I don't, like, especially when we're playing, I don't think it's all about age and everything, and obviously there is respect for people who are older than you, but, you know, other than that, age really doesn't mean as much as it would maybe in just a normal life situation.
What's it like for you other girls? Is it more comfortable with so many youthful players on the tour?
Yeah, I think it's pretty good, but I just see, you know, age is just a number, and, like, that's how I see it, because I feel like we're both all mature, so it's good though to have company, because then you can just talk about stuff outside golf, but like on the golf course. But no, I don't think Lydia plays like she's 16.
Is there much interaction between the veteran players and the younger players?
I've seen a bit, yeah. I would say also with the younger players, for me at least, growing up, I've been playing with them through college and then the younger Canadians that are out here, so it's almost more comfortable to see as many familiar faces around.
Thanks, girls. Play well the rest of the week.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Well, this is for all three of you. Can you talk about the gallery you had out there, what it was like, how it would compare to you know, what you've seen recently in the tour and the conditions of the golf course and all that sort of thing, and how this tournament feels to you?
I'd say we had a great following today, and especially for such an early tee time, and it was nice to see, and a lot of people out there following for the majority of the round, so it's always nice.
Yeah, I'm still kind of, you know, from the solo, I'm still kind of used to the greens being a bit more faster and bouncy, because I only got to see the golf course once, and that was on Tuesday, and I was pretty tired then, so, because I was in the pram yesterday, so it was my first time out there today, and I'm still getting used to what clubs to hit off the tees and stuff, but I think the course is in great condition, but the crowds, we had a nice, you know, following out there today, but the crowds at the Salam was absolutely massive, so I don't think anything will, like, be as big as that.
Yeah, you know, we had crowds, well, it wasn't huge, but we had people watching even from the first hole, and, you know, personally, if one of the players were playing at 7-something, I wouldn't go out at, you know, 7 o'clock to watch people hit. So, yeah, you know, it was really good seeing that people, you know, came out to support us, and, yeah, the course is in really good conditions. I came here early, so I was able to see kind of the progress, and, the greens and stuff was pure when I came, but it's definitely getting better and better.
This is for Lydia. Coming in as defending champ, did it change anything in how you approached the round today? I mean, your score wouldn't indicate any nerves, but how are you feeling coming into the first round of this as defending champ?
You know, it was a pretty special week last year, and no, I didn't have that week coming, so to kind of have that kind of week again this week would be like a double miracle for myself. But yeah, it's, you know, I did feel a little bit of pressure, not from others, but from myself, thinking because you're the defending champion, people are kind of going to expect more, and I'm going to expect more from myself. But I called my dad a couple days ago, and he said, you know, just relax, and can't control everything, and just play the game that you want to play and that you planned.
Thank you.
I have a question for Jennifer. I asked this to a couple of younger Canadian women in the community the other day. Who are your role models, your influences in your career so far?
On the tour here, or just anyone in general?
Yeah.
I mean, I love Tiger, and the fact that I work with Sean, who also works with Tiger, I mean, he's always been a great golfer to look up to. So for the women's side, I mean, obviously Lori Kane is a huge role model for the younger Canadians, and she's very sweet and very comforting to all of us when we're out here. So I would say those.
And just the second question would be, you're obviously a very calm individual. Is that your mother's side or your dad's side? Where does that come from?
I would probably say my dad's side. Yeah, my mom is usually always pretty nervous when she watches me play.
Lydia, how much did it help coming to Edmonton as early as you did?
You know, as you say, when you're on your home course, you know the course really well. So, because I got to play a couple times more than, you know, the other players, I was able to, you know, obviously get a better feel for the course. But that doesn't mean I'll always play better in saying that. But yeah, it was really good to, you know, see the course like a week ago, and yeah, I can notice that the rough is getting longer, the green is getting faster.
No one else has any questions. I have one last one. With you guys, you were talking about the comfort level. Just while you don't play like your age, you do kind of probably have similar interests in terms of being the same age. Any good conversations out there today about topics that maybe you guys kind of shared a common interest in? There was not a ton of, or maybe there wasn't a ton of conversation going on.
Lydia says she's going for a nap, but
yeah,
I might.
Yeah, when I tried to wake up this morning, my eyelids weren't coming up. I was like, oh my God, I'm this tired. But, you know, after you've woken up, you're fine, you're ready to go.
Awesome. Well, congratulations, ladies. Great playing today, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.